Three-dimensional coordinate systems, level 6. In this video, we're going to go over three slightly more complicated problems that require the use of the distance formula in three dimensions. Let's try the first example. Find the lengths of the sides of the triangle PQR with the given vertices and determine whether the triangle is a right triangle, an isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle, or neither. How do we determine what type of triangle these three points form? What depends? Say we have triangle ABC. If this triangle was an equilateral triangle, then the length of each of its sides would be the same, meaning that the length of line segment AB is equal to line segment AC, which is also equal to line segment BC. If the triangle were to be an isosceles triangle, then two of its sides would have to be the same, meaning that the length of line segment AB equals line segment AC, or line segment AB equals line segment BC, or line segment AC equals line segment BC. If the triangle were to be a right triangle, then we can use the converse of the Pythagorean theorem. Let's assume that in this diagram, line segment BC is a hypotenuse, meaning it's the longest side of the triangle. If the sum of the squares of the other two line segments, in this case AB and AC, are equal to the square of line segment BC, then the triangle is a right triangle. In any case, we need to find the lengths of each line segment. So let's go ahead and use the distance formula to find the length of each of the three line segments. The length of line segment PR can be found by using the coordinates of point P and R as follows. We go ahead and square the difference and simplify it by adding the sum. Doing that, we obtain the square root of 14. Notice that we cannot simplify this radical since the factors of 14 are 7 and 2. None of these are a square number. In the same manner, we find the length of line segment QR by using the coordinates of point Q and R, as follows. We go ahead and square the difference and simplify it by adding the sum. Doing that, we obtain the square root of 45. We can simplify this radical by breaking apart 45 into a product of a square number and one of its factors, in this case, 9 times 5. Simplifying the expression, we obtain 3 root 5. Finally, we find the length of line segment PQ by using the coordinates of point P and Q as follows. We go ahead and square the difference and simplify it by adding the sum. Doing that, we obtain the square root of 59. We cannot simplify the expression because 59 is a prime number, so we leave the expression as it is. Having found the length of all the line segments of triangle PQR, we go ahead and start comparing the sides to determine what type of triangle the points form. Let's check to see if it's an equilateral triangle, meaning is the length of all three sides equal? In this case, no. Every single line segment has a different length, so we can eliminate this triangle from being an equilateral triangle or isosceles triangle. Let's test to see if it's a right triangle. We first need to identify the hypotenuse and the legs of the triangle. Remember, the hypotenuse is always the longest side of a right triangle. In this case, line segment PQ is a hypotenuse, and line segment QR and PR are the legs. Next, let's verify that the Pythagorean theorem is true, meaning that the length of line segment PQ squared is equal to the length of line segment QR squared plus the length of line segment PR squared. So we go ahead and substitute the values of each line segment into the equation. Next, we go ahead and square the values. Simplifying this expression and adding the values on the right side of the equation, we obtain 59 is equal to 59. So it checks out. Hence, by the converse of the Pythagorean theorem, triangle PQR is a right triangle, with the right angle located at vertex R. Alright, let's try the second example. If line L passes through the point A with coordinates 1, 2, 3, and is perpendicular to the xy plane, what are the coordinates of the points that lie on line L that are at a distance of 7 from point B with coordinates 3, negative 1, and 5? Alright, let's first draw a diagram so we have an idea of what we're dealing with. Let's first plot point A with coordinates 1, 2, and 3. Now, the problem states that line L passes through point A. In addition, we also know that this line is perpendicular to the xy plane, meaning it forms a right angle with this plane, as follows. This is a visual representation of line L that is perpendicular to the xy plane and passes through point A. The problem is asking us to find the points that lie on this line L that are at a distance of 7 from point B with coordinates 3, negative 1, and 5. So essentially, we're looking for all the points that lie on this line that are at a distance of 7 from point B. Since we are dealing with the distance between two points, it makes sense to use the distance formula in three dimensions. In order to use this formula, we need two points. Since we are trying to find the distance from point B to a point on the line, we will assign point B as point 1 and the point located on the line as point 2. Let's label this point as point P. Now, notice that we know the coordinates of point B. They are 3, negative 1, and 5. But how about the coordinates of point P? Well, let's take a closer look at the diagram. We know the line L passes through the points 1, 2, 3, and that it's also perpendicular to the xy plane. This means that any point on this line will have its x and y coordinates fixed. They will not change. So every point that lies in this line will be guaranteed to have an x coordinate of 1 and a y coordinate of 2. So point P should have 1 and 2 as its x coordinate and y coordinate respectively. In addition, since this line is perpendicular to the xy plane, the z coordinates of every single point that lie in this line will be distinct, since the points are free to move along this line in both the positive z direction and negative z direction. Since the values of z can change, we will assign the variable z as the z coordinate for point P. Now that we have values for the coordinates of point P, let's go ahead and apply the distance formula. Substituting the coordinates for point P and B, we have the following. We also know the distance from point B to point P has to equal 7. So we set this expression equal to 7. Notice that this problem reduces to finding the value of the z coordinates of point P. So let's go ahead and solve for z. First, we simplify the difference of the x and y coordinates. Then we go ahead and square them and collect like terms, leaving the quantity z minus 5 squared intact. Next, we go ahead and square both sides of the equation as follows. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Next, we subtract 13 from both sides. Then we go ahead and take the square root of both sides. Here we have to be careful. Recall that when you take the square root of a quantity squared, this expression reduces to the absolute value of the quantity. Alternatively, we can take the square root of both sides, with the square root of 36 being equal to positive and negative 6. In either case, we have two distinct equations for which we need to solve for z. So solving for z on both equations, we obtain z equals 11 and z equals negative 1. Notice that we obtain two answers. This means that there are actually two distinct points that lie on line L for which they are at a distance of 7 from point B. The first of these is the point with coordinates 1, 2, 11, and the second point has coordinates 1, 2, and negative 1. Alright, let's try the final example. Find the point on the y-axis equidistant from the points 2, 5, negative 3, and negative 3, 6, 1. Alright, let's go ahead and plot the first point and label it as point A. Let's also plot the second point and label it as point B. This time around, the question is asking us to find the point that lies on the y-axis that is equidistant to these two points. Let's label this point as point P. Mathematically, we are trying to find the point for which the distance between point P and A is equal to the distance between point P and B. We can find the distance between each point by using the distance formula in three dimensions. But first, we need the coordinates of point P. From the problem, we know that point P lies on the y-axis. This means that the x and z coordinate remain constant. Specifically, both the x and z coordinates are equal to 0, leaving the y-coordinate of point P free to change. So we will assign this coordinate with the variable y. Now that we have the coordinates of point P, let's go ahead and apply the distance formula to both line segments. The distance from point P to point A is represented as follows. And the distance from point P to point B is represented as follows. Next, we go ahead and simplify both sides by squaring the difference of the x and z coordinates, leaving the difference of the y coordinates intact for now. Next, we go ahead and square both sides to eliminate the square root from both sides. Then we go ahead and simplify the expressions. Now let's go ahead and expand the binomial from each side of the equation. Doing that, we have the following. We can eliminate the y squared term by subtracting it from both sides. Next is just a matter of solving for y by collecting like terms and isolating the variable. Doing that, we have that y is equal to 4. So the point that is equidistant to both point A and point B that lies on the y-axis is a point with coordinates 0, 4, 0. Alright, in our next video, we will start solving basic problems that require the use of the equation of a sphere.